Central Asia and to many Buddhists, Tibet is known as the pure land of the Buddha. Here for well over 1,000 years, the teachings of Lord Buddha have been practiced and preserved. Buddhism was actively patronized by the state and affected every Tibetan's thoughts and acts. His Holiness the 14th reincarnated Dalai Lama is both religious and secular leader to the Tibetan people. In this film, he is about to enter a very important stage of his life. Like every Lama or monk who aspires to the coveted title of Geshe, or Doctor of Theology, he must first undergo a rigorous examination. In the Valley of Lhasa, capital city of Tibet, His Holiness and his retinue are proceeding on their journey to Ganden Monastery. Accompanied by civil, military, lay, and monk officials, the procession makes a splendid sight for the people of Lhasa gathered to see the departure. Ordinarily, a monk may pass his examination at any of the three great monasteries near Lhasa, or at the combined meeting of the monks of these monasteries during the Mun Lam, or January prayer festival. However, as the head of all monasteries, the Dalai Lama must sit for separate examinations at the monasteries of Serat, Drepung, and Ganden, and finally at the Mun Lam festival in the central cathedral of Lhasa. At this stage of the journey, His Holiness is transported in the royal palanquin, which Tibetans call Pepchong. Close behind the palanquin follow cabinet ministers and the Dalai Lama's personal tutors. Along the roadside are government officials in ancient costumes dating back to the early kings of Tibet and worn only on very special occasions. At wayside stops, representatives from the area wait to greet the Dalai Lama. Ganden Monastery is about 40 miles east of Lhasa. From this point on, the terrain becomes steep, and palanquin gives way to a more practical kind of transportation. Ganden Monastery, founded by Tsongkhapa in 1409, is the third largest monastery in Tibet, housing 3,300 monks. It is an established tradition for all visiting Dalai Lamas to dismount and prostrate themselves before the golden mausoleum in which the mortal remains of Tsongkhapa are preserved. Tsongkhapa literally means the man from Onion Land, which is descriptive of his humble beginnings. But he was to become one of the greatest scholars of Tibet, revered as the founder of the Gelugpa sect. Incense is burned from the roof of the monastery, signaling the approach of the Dalai Lama. Under the golden roof lies the tomb of Tsongkhapa. The assembled monks are gathered in the examination area as His Holiness, his advisors, and ministers arrive. Many different schools of Buddhist thought in Tibet. However, the difference between them lies solely in their method of teaching and their devotion to the founder or Lama, and in the character of their rituals, not in fundamental religion and philosophy. Their inspiration and goal are the same: salvation or final escape from rebirth, with the attainment of nirvana. And although each sect has its own leader, they are all joined under the guidance of His Holiness the Dalai Lama. There are many orders of Geshe, the highest being the Tlarampa. On the average, a monk spends 20 to 30 years in hard study at the monasteries in order to pass the examination for the degree of Geshe. The examination is conducted orally and in the form of debates, which cover such subjects as Buddhist philosophy, transcendental wisdom, metaphysics, logic, and dialectics. The debates are attended and judged by the abbots of the monasteries and other learned men. The examination debate proceeds with syllogisms, examples, quotations, in a rapid fire of questions and answers, which testify to the candidate's mastery of the subject. In all religious debate and discussion, the original teachings of Buddha and the commentaries of the pandits are constantly cited to authenticate the validity of the points being debated. Tibetans believe it is as important to be able to ask the right questions as it is to answer. Therefore, at the end of each examination, the candidate, in this case the Dalai Lama himself, is tested for his ability to question his examiners. The gestures made by both examiner and candidate are quite meaningful. Raising the right hand symbolizes an act of rising to the state of enlightenment. The lowering of the left hand signifies suppression of ignorance and delusion. The clapping of hands indicates that an answer should be given. The display of banners and awnings signify an auspicious occasion. With the completion of the examination, His Holiness leaves the monastery, preceded by monks carrying incense burners, while behind him follow two monks carrying umbrellas, one of peacock feathers, the other of yellow silk, denoting the Dalai Lama's rank. From all the surrounding villages, Tibetans have come to Ganden in the hope of seeing His Holiness. They pitch tents for shelter during their stay. Now that the official ceremony is over, the entourage goes on a sightseeing tour. Astride sure-footed yaks, native to Tibet, they climb to the top of Mount Ongkuri. From the summit of the mountain, there is a vast panoramic view. Prayer flags are a familiar sight throughout Tibet. Prayers are printed on paper and cloth and strung across the high mountain passes and peaks frequented by travelers. the procession reaches the wayside tents of the Dalai Lama, abbots, monks, and local people come to pay their respect to His Holiness. Seated on the traditional shukri, he receives the visitors, who prostrate themselves on leaving as a gesture of reverence and farewell. Majestically over the city of Lhasa is the Potala, winter palace of the Dalai Lama, centuries old, with more than 1,000 rooms. In the heart of Lhasa is Chokhang Cathedral, built in the 7th century by Songtsen Gampo, 33rd king of Tibet. This gigantic cathedral accommodates more than 20,000 monks during the prayer festival. And it is here that the final examination will take place. This most difficult stage of initiation lasts 10 hours, and more than 50 examiners will take part in the questioning. They include abbots and geshes from the two tantric colleges of Lhasa, in addition to the learned lamas and monks from all the corners of Tibet. The golden roofs of Chokhang welcome the procession as it enters the examination area. During the examination, government officials and other spectators look on from their balcony positions. Once more, a lifetime of intensive religious training and reflection on the part of the Dalai Lama is put to test. Many of the questions asked during the debates relate to the Four Noble Truths: suffering, the origin of suffering, the cessation of suffering, and the path which leads to its cessation. These constitute the basis of Buddhist philosophy. The question may be asked, is there nirvana, or state of complete enlightenment? Or the candidate may be challenged with the question, how do we know there is an afterlife? The final examination is over, and His Holiness has acquitted himself with honor. With the religious ceremony at an end, government officials take their leave. Now is the time to celebrate the success of the Dalai Lama's examinations and attainment of geshe.